Hello and welcome to St. David's Episcopal Church. My name is Douglas Buchanan and it's my great joy to be music director here at St. David's. At the beginning of each of our music series events, we include a land acknowledgement. In some parts of the world, these statements are so formulaic and commonplace that they are performative. However, in this area, they are relatively rare, so we find that it is meaningful in terms of our action, in terms of our hopes for justice and equity through the world, to include it to better educate ourselves and our guests. We acknowledge with humility that the lands where we gather today are the traditional ancestral and unceded lands of Piscataway, Lenape, and Susquehannock Indigenous peoples. The vast coastal area today known as Baltimore City, Maryland, sustained Indigenous peoples until the arrival of Europeans in the 1600s. Over the next 400 years, many Piscataway, Lenape, and Susquehannock communities were decimated, absorbed by larger villages or tribes, and/or forced by the U.S. federal government to move west beyond the Mississippi River with larger tribes. Since then, other tribal peoples have moved here in diaspora, including Lumbee peoples. On January 9, 2012, two tribes of Piscataway, the Piscataway-Conoy tribe and the Piscataway Indian Nation, became the first tribes recognized by the state of Maryland. In 2017, the state also recognized the Akahanok Indian tribe. We acknowledge that we are standing on stolen lands. We also acknowledge the history of this specific location, now known as Roland Park, which during the early years of the 19th century was used as a wheat farm by Robert Goodloe Harper, a white man who wrongfully claimed ownership over 9 enslaved black persons. In the early 1890s, this neighborhood was begun as the first planned suburb community in the country. By 1912, Roland Park deeds explicitly forbade any black person to live within the environs, with the exception of, quote, domestic servants. Persons of Jewish faith were also not sold deeds during this time. Though this discrimination was deemed illegal in a 1948 Supreme Court ruling, the larger history of systemic racism continues to impact this neighborhood, Baltimore, and our country to this day. This land acknowledgement is, by its very nature, incomplete, for no one acknowledgement can fully do justice to the history of colonialism, which impacted the indigenous persons and later to black persons who called and call this land home. It therefore represents one aspect of our ongoing commitment to the work of learning actively and honestly engaging with the history of colonization and our roles in this history, as well as seeking to take steps, incomplete and imperfect though they may be, to live into the work of decolonization and anti-racism. To learn more, I hope you will continue to explore the events that St. David's has to offer, including our Evensong series, each which deals with a theme of social justice, and our weekly liturgies, which always include a work by a historically marginalized demographic. I continue to try to expand the canon as much as possible. It's also wonderful to be able to work with musicians and artists who delve into the traditional canon in new and wonderful ways. And that is what I always find when working with Aya. You may have recognized me this evening from my other illustrious roles as guy with the credit card reader, guy putting up the signs, and guy starting the live stream. But one of my favorite roles is to act as collaborator and composer, and I'm very lucky to have been able to do that with Aya multiple times. I first wrote a piece for Aya back in 2014. If you followed them and heard some of their music, you might recognize Batter My Heart, Three-Personed God from their Heart Form program. That's a piece of mine and one of the pieces that I love the most of the things that have fallen out of my brain. During the pandemic, Aya and I came up with this program, The Unicorn. There's lots of different resources on Aya's website that you can learn a little bit more about the germination of this, as well as reading Allison's wonderful program notes in your program today, which that collaboration culminated in my writing another piece for them, and so you'll be able to see me at the end of the program as guy who wrote some music that they will sing. I'm so pleased to see so many wonderful, eager faces to experience some beautiful, mystical medieval music tonight. A few notes, if you do need to use the restroom, I would go to the back of the church and then around this side. You can go out this side door and halfway down the hall there are restrooms on either side. If you are moved by tonight's music, please feel free to make a donation. Everything that you give goes directly to supporting arts in the community. We always make our concerts free, so anyone who wants to experience beauty and wonder are able to do so. So any donation that you give helps to make that happen. If you are interested in learning more about the St. David's Music Series, there is you can read about it in your program. There is also a link to sign up for our music series e-news. I promise that I don't harass anyone too much. But our 2022-2023 season announcement is coming soon with a lot of wonderful things now that we're able to plan a little bit more normally, maybe, for next season. We hope. We're still in the midst of things, but things are looking more and more hopeful. Also, feel free to check out Aya's website with some wonderful merchandise, including their CDs, as well as new Hildegard von Bingen t-shirts. Now, I don't know about you, but I need to get myself a Hildegard von Bingen t-shirt because summer is coming and I don't have my requisite Hildegard von Bingen summer wear. So make sure that you put that on your list of things to get before June hits. I want to get out of the way now because I want us to be able to dive in and experience this wonderful mystical event that Aya has so carefully put together. It does include some of the virtual pieces that were put together last year as we sort of live in this liminal space between the physical and the spiritual. We also think about that liminal space that we entered into for the last couple of years where we were both physically present with ourselves but often only virtually present with others. So this becomes, in part, an exploration of that. There'll be plenty of live music, though. The last note is to please silence any electronic devices that you have with you. We appreciate sounds of all kinds, but I don't know if cell phones are tuned in Gothic harp intonation. And very lastly, we would ask that simply hold applause until the end of the program. You'll find that we enter into a meditative space that where the silence will allow a sense of fullness. So no need to applaud until the very end. The nice thing for me is that my piece is last, so that's an extra bonus for me. I so appreciate seeing you all here, and I appreciate Aya being here to offer some wonderful music. Please join me in welcoming them.
Thank you. He's a little